Today, we create this traditional German joint with a 3D printed jig. While most of my projects are inspired by a problem, the inspiration for this project was the cover of a book with this joint. I knew immediately that I would like to be able to use this joint in my projects, but I would never be patient enough to cut it by hand. So I started my trusty OpenSCAD and designed a shape that will serve as a template for my router. I won't go through the details of the modeling, but if you're interested, I have a link to another video where I explain how to use OpenSCAD in the description. Basically, I create a couple of circles and combine them with a hole. For the negative form, I use a larger hole and cut it out from a solid cube. I then move the negative form a bit backwards to create a shoulder in the final piece. I also add a few structures in order to later clamp the jig to the workpiece. If you want to print this jig for yourself, go to the Thingiverse website and customize your own version for free with setting a few parameters such as the width and height of the dovetail, the depth of the shoulder, size of your router bit and guide bushing, and the size of the platform supporting the router. The link to the model is in the description. The default version is configured for M5 screws, but you can also change the size in the settings. Insert the right size nuts in the slots at one part and the corresponding screws in the other part. To create a joint, use a combination square and place the jig centered on your workpiece and align the backside square to the stock. Now pull the screws tight. I support the workpiece with a part of a tailed print that has the same thickness. And on the table saw, I've cut a piece of wood to the height of the workpiece with the jig attached to it to support the router. Now I use my router with the guide bushing to remove the material from both sides. And we are done. The joint can be glued together. The joint shows a small gap of around 0.5 millimeter, which I fill with sawdust. Despite the gap, the joint is quite strong as there's a lot of long grain to long grain glue surface. If you like the combination of 3D printing and woodworking, please check out some of my other videos and subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram if you want to have a look at future projects.